Koko was born to her mother Jacqueline in 1971 at the San Francisco Zoo.
She's accepted the child and she's proceeding to raise it. The gorilla population is declining, and I think we're sort of becoming a Noah's Ark.
When Koko was born, Penny and Ron, already a budding photographer, were both students nearby at Stanford University.
I was a graduate student, and we met at one of Penny's friends' parties or something, and I got her phone number. She was definitely the most beautiful woman I'd ever seen. I'm sure you won't put that in, but she was.
Penny was a 24-year-old studying psychology at Stanford when the field of animal communication was going through a revolution.
Do this, Vicky. Another sound resembles the letter K. Vicky, sit up, girl. Come on.
Earlier attempts had tried to teach spoken language, for instance, and they can't generate the sounds. They don't have the control of the lips and tongue the way we do. And somebody had the wit to teach sign language, you know, to his chimp, Washo.
In the 60s, Washo was raised like a child by husband and wife, Alan and Beatrix Gardner. They claimed she could use 350 signs to communicate.
I had attended a lecture by the Gardners at Stanford and was really interested in that research. I just felt, this is it. This is what I need to do.